Dear colleagues, thank you for the opportunity to meet with you again to talk about what's going on with NIH Extramural during the COVID-19 public health crisis. We know that this has been a difficult time for probably all of you. We've heard about laboratories being shuttered or dramatically slowed down, people not able to come to work, teleworking, lots of stress, and we are well aware of the many disruptions that are occurring and the many anxieties that you're facing. I'd like to take this opportunity to review some of the frequently asked questions that we have received over the last few days. I would note that all of the questions that I'm going to address have been posted on our website. That website has been growing over the past week or two. Please take a look at it often. But everything that I'm going to say here is on that website, so you should take a look at it. Let me start with a wonderful question, in a way, which is that many of you would like to donate equipment or materials or supplies that you purchased with NIH grants to help the coronavirus effort. For example, personal protective equipment, PPE. And the question is, can you do it? And the answer is absolutely yes. Please go ahead and do that. That's a wonderful thing to do. And then later on, you can work with us about obtaining potential administrative supplements to cover those costs. But the most important thing is, please don't let us stop you from helping this nation deal with this public health crisis that we're currently dealing with. And along the same lines, we've also had questions about staff being allowed to work on, staff being allowed to go to clinical work. We know, of course, that in many parts of the country, clinical responsibilities are increasing because of the need to take care of coronavirus patients. Please go ahead and do that. Take care of your patients. That is absolutely paramount, and then worry about us later. Okay, so now let me work through some of the other questions that we have received. So one question is, well, what about grants that have been received or are being received and peer review? Is peer review still happening? Are we still processing grants? The answer is absolutely yes. We are holding every peer review meeting. We're holding them virtually. But the grants that have come in and the grants that are continuing to come in are being reviewed, and we have every intention of processing them, even though we, like you, are also largely in a telework situation. Okay, next question is, what about emergency supplements? As many of you know, Congress passed some supplemental funds. These are funds that are specifically targeted towards coronavirus research, and they fit under an emergency FOA, which we published a couple of weeks ago. Please go to our website, and on that website, we will identify for you where those opportunities exist to submit competing revisions that would be funded out of those emergency supplemental funds. These are special notices of special interest. Okay, another question is, what about no-cost extensions? Are we going to allow no-cost extensions? The answer to that is absolutely yes. We're going to be more flexible with no-cost extensions than we normally are. So for example, if you want to go to a second year of no-cost extension and need to do that because of a COVID-19 related effect, you'll be able to do that. We're getting a lot of questions about salary support. We understand that because of the change in work status and because of the need for some faculty to be diverted to clinical duties, that research productivity is going to be decreasing over this period of time. And the question is, can you continue to charge salary as you have been on grants, even though there's going to be a marked reduction in productivity while this crisis unfolds? And the answer to that is absolutely yes. If you've got specific questions about your grants, and this is true, by the way, for all the questions, please contact your program staff or your grants management staff, and they'll be able to help you. You do not, and I've said this before, but this is so important, I want to say this again, you do not need our approval to divert to clinical responsibilities. Please take care of your patients. That's absolutely paramount. That is the first priority, and then worry about us later. Okay, next question is whether or not it is allowable to shift money on a grant to coronavirus-related research if that research is out of scope with the with the grant itself? And the answer to that is no. If you're going to go out of scope, the only way that that can be done is through what we call a competitive revision. Now, we have competitive revision opportunities. They're already posted on our website. I anticipate that there will be more such opportunities. We are processing them very quickly. In fact, a number of awards have already been given. So that's what you should be looking for. But you cannot divert money from one kind of research to another if it's out of scope from what the original project was. Okay. The next question has to do with administrative supplements. We're getting a lot of questions about administrative supplements. And so I'd like to use this opportunity to give you some general guidelines. Administrative supplements could be considered for a number of reasons during this period of disruption. We don't know what the length of disruption is going to be, what the extent of disruption is going to be, and at this point, you don't know what impact it's going to have on your research. So for the most part, it's probably way too premature to be submitting administrative supplement requests related to COVID-19 until some more time has passed. During the time that passes, two things should happen. One is that you'll have a better sense as to what the impact of the disruption has been on your research. And the second is that you will have had an opportunity to speak with our staff and get some more general guidance. Now, there are two major exceptions to this. One is if you're applying for supplements for coronavirus-related research. These are the supplement opportunities that we've posted on our website and in the NIH guide. There, absolutely, now is the time. We want you to be looking for supplement support. We want you to be doing the work. And the second is if there's something going on with your project that is absolutely mission critical right now, that really cannot wait. These might be the normal reasons why you might ask for an administrative supplement. So just to repeat this, the general principle is that for the most part, it's premature to be thinking about and asking for administrative supplements for COVID-19 related issues. We need some time to go by so we have a better sense as to what is going on. You have an opportunity to speak with NIH staff. The two exceptions are coronavirus-related research and mission-critical issues. Another question is whether or not it is necessary to record in clinicaltrials.gov changes to your protocol if you're conducting a clinical trial. Say you're conducting a clinical trial, and because of COVID-19 related issues, you have to change the protocol in some kind of meaningful way. Does that have to be recorded in clinicaltrials.gov? And the answer to that is yes. Our clinicaltrials.gov staff will be happy to help you if you need that. We're getting a lot of questions about training. People are wondering about phased awards like K99 R00 awards. People are wondering about K awards and training awards where there may be a loss of time because of the current public health crisis. The general principle is that we want to be as accommodating and as flexible as possible, and that we will be particularly flexible with extending time. So for example, let's say that you're on a fellowship award, you're drawn away for a period of time, you're not able to do your research. Now, after several months have gone by, you've been able to come back and do your research. Question is whether NIH would offer an extension. And the answer to that is yes. Now, you do need to be in contact with us and go over with us the specifics of your situation, but we will be as accommodating as we can be, and in general, we will offer extensions. The final question I want to address is early stage investigators. Of course, this is one of our highest priorities, has been one of our highest priorities, is to nurture the next generation of researchers. Some early stage investigators are wondering whether or not they would be able to extend their early stage investigator eligibility because of delays that occur as a result of the coronavirus situation. And the answer to that is yes, but it has to be handled in a standard way. So if you go to our ESI website, You can get information about how to request an extension. We will do this in a streamlined, rapid manner. But as always, we want to do whatever we can to support the next generation of researchers. I hope you have found this information useful. But more importantly, please take care. Please be well. And please follow our website often. There's a lot of information there. We hope that you find it useful. And for information that you don't see, please send us your questions so that we can make our FAQs and our service to you better as the days go by. Take care.